Hi, my name's Ed, and we're going to be talking about the laser datum on the Zed head. First of all, what's it for? Well, normally you would set your XY datum with your tool, but that can take a bit of time because you've got the thickness of the tool and the spindle's in the center of the Zed head. So finding that center can take a bit of time. With the laser datum, it's at the front and it shows you a crosshair, which makes it much faster to set the XY datum. If you like quick turnarounds, you're really going to enjoy this feature. And before we go into calibration and enabling, I'm going to give you a quick tour as to what it can do. So in this example, I want to be setting my XY datum on this corner of my stock. So to do that, I'm going to navigate the Z head so the crosshairs intersect that corner. I'll be using the manual move function and I'll just move it around so it's in the ballpark area. I'll switch, now I'm close, I'm going to switch to millimeter increments. And quickly just position that crosshair over the corner of my stock. Now I'm happy with that, I want to push the set XY datum button. Yes, and when I do this, you'll see the Z head as a check function, move the Z head over that datum so that I'll be able to see that the tool is perfectly positioned over the corner of my stock. Great, happy with that, I'm good to go. Before first use, we need to calibrate the laser datum offset. What this means is we're going to set the distance between the crosshair and the center of the tool. We do all of this on the console and we've got a really nice intuitive app to guide us through how to do it. You'll need to do calibration if this is the first time that you're setting up SmartBench, or if you've replaced the Z head, or if you've moved the laser. Basically, anything that could have changed the distance between the center of that crosshair and the center of the tool. To do calibration, you'll need three things. First of all, you need SmartBench with a laser. You need some scrap material and a tool in the spindle already loaded. I've already set my upper beam to be at the right height so that it's over that material. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make a mark on that scrap piece of material. And the app is going to walk us through making that mark and then moving the Z head so that the laser crosshair aligns perfectly with that mark. By jogging the Z head over to that mark, SmartBench knows how far you've moved that Z head. And so therefore, you're telling it what that offset is. I'm going to navigate to the maintenance app, go through the lobby to find that. And the first tab is the laser datum setup. So I've got some buttons here which are going to be useful. I can turn the vacuum on and off. I can turn the spindle on and off. I can move the Z head around. I can move the Z axis up and down as well. And these tools are everything that I need to create a mark in my scrap material. We're going to walk through this calibration together, but if you need any reminders, this information button here will give you a useful pop-up as to what we're going to do. Okay, now we've got our tool close to our top surface of that scrap material. We're going to make a really small mark. So to do that, I'm going to put my dust cover into the dust chute. I'm going to make sure I'm on a millimeter increment so that I can just nudge that tool down when it's spinning until it makes a mark and then I can back it off. I'm going to start the tool and then I'm going to move the Z head down to make that mark. Start the tool now. Nudge down. Made that mark. Lift it back up. Turn the tool off. I'll now go into quick lift mode. And I'm just going to, when it stops spinning, pull out the dust chute plug and I can clearly see my mark in there. Now we've made our mark, we're going to move the Z head so the crosshairs are over that mark. But before we do that, it's very important that we push the reset button. What that's doing is it's throwing away the old setting and it's telling SmartBench to record the distance that we move for the crosshair to land in the center of the mark. So we'll push our reset button and confirm that the Z head hasn't moved since making that mark. And now we'll navigate the Z head so that the crosshairs are directly over the mark that we've just made. And now I'm going to switch to 0.1 millimeter increments so that I can really get the center of that crosshair directly over the mark. Now I'm happy that the laser crosshair is over my mark. I'm going to push the save button and say, yep, that is my offset. Setting saved. And now that's saved, next time we use our laser to set our XY datum, it will apply that offset. Let's talk about using that laser to set the XY datum. When the laser is enabled, whenever you try and set the datum, it'll give you a choice. Do you want to use the laser crosshairs or do you want to use the center of the tool? We'll do a quick example of each one of those cases now. And for both of those examples, I'm going to be targeting the corner of this piece of stock. Our first case will be to use the laser datum. So I've already honed the machine and I'm now going to navigate the Z head so that the crosshair covers that corner of that piece of stock. I'm using the infinity move. Bit of an overshoot there. So now I'll back off to 10 millimeter increments just to get close to the zone. And now to 1 millimeter increments, moving in so that that laser crosshair is good. And now I'm going to push set to set that XY datum on the screen. I'll be presented with this question, do I want to use the laser datum? In this case, the tick is present. And so I say, yes, I want to use the laser datum. As soon as that happens, the Z head moves the tool over to that position. Really is a check and a reminder to me that everything's fine and that center of the tool is exactly where I want it to be. The second case is, for whatever reason, I've decided that I want to use the center of the tool to define my datum. So now I'm going to navigate the Z head so the center of the tool is over the corner of the stock, and then I'll hit set. Again, I'll do that using the navigation buttons, but it's going to be a bit more involved because I'm going to have to guess a little bit more as to where the center of that tool is. So I'm using the infinity move. I'm going to have to drop my Z head down a little bit so I get really good eyes on that tool. And now I'm going to increment over in 10 mil steps just to get in the ballpark. Now I'm going to my 1 millimeter. I can approximate that to be the millimeter. I'm really getting my head down to get a good line of sight. There, I'm happy with that in the y-axis. And now I need to adjust in the x-axis. That's much more difficult, but I'm happy with that. That's a pretty good approximate. Now I'm happy with the position of the tool. I'm going to press set. But this time, because I'm not using the laser datum, I'm going to deselect the tick from this question. Is this where you want to set your XY datum? Yes, and I've taken the tick away, so it's not going to be using the laser's position. And now I press yes. Goes green because that means that it's received the command and it's not moving because it's already where the datum position is. If you find that you don't use the laser to set your XY datum, you can turn it off at any time. This will mean that you won't get asked what you're using when you set the XY datum. SmartBench will just assume that you're using the tool center. To disable the laser datum, we're simply going to go into the maintenance app and turn it off. But don't worry, SmartBench will remember the offset. So if you want to turn it back on again, you don't have to go through recalibration. Let's talk about the sharpness of that laser beam. Now, the Z head comes with the laser already focused, so you shouldn't have to adjust it. But if the Z head takes a knock or you're replacing the laser, then you'll need to know how to set that focus. The laser comes in two parts. It's got a barrel and an adjustable focus ring on the end. The laser is held at the front of the Z-head in this clamping bracket and can be adjusted by slackening the bolt at the front of the bracket. With the laser unclamped, I can now push that laser down to access the focus ring at the bottom of the barrel and rotate that to adjust its focus. By rotating the focus ring to sharpen the laser, we're also moving the crosshair around, which takes it out of alignment. So if you want to bring that back, you just twist the barrel back to compensate. Now I'm happy that my beam is sharp. I'm going to replace the barrel of the laser and retighten the clamping bolt. It's important to note that the bottom of the focus ring should be flush with the bottom of the mounting clamp. And with that focus ring flush with the clamp, I'm now going to retighten the clamping bolt to lock it in place. That's everything on the Laser Datum. Hope that's been helpful. See you in the next one.